I'm originally from a little town down in Georgia called Statesboro, and my family all is still down in Georgia. They haven't yet forgiven me for leaving home when I was 17 and going to Boston and, you know, saying, I'm never coming back. And, boy, you know, you can leave your roots, but your roots never leave you. And I realized as I was sort of running away at 17 and going up to Boston to go to school and play music, I realized that no matter how hard I worked to lose my accent, which I worked very hard to lose my accent, it's always right there under the surface, you know? So if I talk to my sister-in-law, who's from South Carolina, and she talks like this, I just fall right in there with her. It's just fine. But I'm from a little town called Statesboro, and when my older brothers were at the age where they would go to, you know, high school dances and such, there was a band that used to play at the high school, and I think they paid a couple bucks, which seemed outrageous to them at the time. They were a local band, Georgia band, called the Almond Brothers. How cool is that? And the Almond Brothers used to do a song called Statesboro Blues, and I just thought that was so cool that there was a song about the town where I was born. And it ends up, many years later, I found out it's a great traditional blues song written by a guy named Blind Willie McTell. It's been done by everybody from Taj Mahal to Bonnie Raitt to the Almond Brothers, and none of them were born there, and they did a great job with it. So I'm figuring since I was born there, I have the birthright to play it. So, Statesboro Blues, Blind Willie McTell.
She's got 'em. When I woke up this morning,